Hey guys, it's Bia here again, and this is a really short video just to for the people out there that are doing A-levels and not GCSEs. If you watched my last video, I showed you this book, and this book is was the key to me getting all of my A's and A stars for GCSE. Like, it was so crucial, you don't even understand. So if you want to know more about this, go and watch the video. I will leave a link up here to the video. So if you want to watch that, you can do that. So there's a difference between GCSE and A-levels, because GCSE you have a lot of subjects. Like, I did like 12 different subjects. That's crazy. I was crazy, I swear. I don't know how I did it. But I made it, and possibly due to this book helping me, so just saying, you might want to try it out as a tip, as a technique. For A-levels it's a bit different, because each subject has much more content. So there is much more content when it comes to A-levels for each individual subject, hence why for GCSE you do like, I did like 12, but for A-levels I'm doing 5. Actually, yeah, 5, because I have Portuguese, and Portuguese is like an extra one, because they allow you to do like an extra A-level just on your language, because it's like, it's easy for you, so it's like a easy way to get extra points. So if you do speak another language, you might want to do that. You might want to ask your school to do that, your college. So yeah, but my three main subjects that I actually have to revise for are maths, business, and Spanish. I'm also doing art A-level, but that doesn't really require any studying. It's just like coursework, and the coursework does take a lot of time. That is like the subject I spend 80% of my time on. I spend more time doing that one subject than all of the other subjects. It's like, it's crazy, but I think it's worth it. So if you want to do art A-level, go for it, okay? Especially because you don't have to revise for anything. It's just like, it's all down to how much work you put in the beginning. And then when it gets to the final exam, if you finish early, if you get everything done, that is it. You don't have to do anything else after it. After April, you're finished. You have free time to just do these other subjects. Some people actually just do 3. So, actually, I think most people do 3, but I'm just so extra, so I do 4, 5. So, I have these 3 little books, and each one is for a different subject, so I did it differently because the content for each one is slightly different, and the way you revise for each one is different. So for business is like mostly like the way you study for business is like the way you study for science, like biology or chemistry, or I don't know what other subjects, like maybe history. Yeah, history probably as well. So this is just like revise the content, the things you need to know, especially for businesses, like the advantages and disadvantages. I've never seen a subject that does like so much focus on like the advantages and disadvantages of something. So you just revise the content, and then you have the exam. We have 2 exams in AS, and there's 3 exams in A level. And with this, it's kind of like exactly the same way I did for this book, where you just you write all the content and then you revise it. So I usually keep these books in my bag, just in case I ever want something. And especially this book, because it's really easy to revise for this subject, so I will keep it, and I'll just, whenever I'm like bored, or I have nothing I can do on the bus, or like I'm on my way home, or whatever, I will revise, like do a really quick revision. It doesn't even have to be like intense revision, as long as you do something, and then you read over, and you're like, oh, I understand this, I understand the concept. It's much easier for you when you're like doing your exams. Then for Spanish, which is like English, we need to do a film and a play, And we also have the listening and reading and writing, like listening and reading and writing exam, which is like they speak, you just like write some things about what they speak. So it's kind of simple. The writing exam is the is like, I don't want to say the worst, but it's like the hardest one, because it's the one you have to do more for. Also, there's a speaking exam. But difference to Spanish, because this is a different language, this is not my language. I have like the first half of this mini book. It's just translations of words. Words I didn't know when I read them. So I wrote it down, and then later on I went back to it and I was like, oh, okay. Sometimes I go through this, I'm like, do I know that word? Do I know that? Okay, that's what it means. Okay, do I know this word? Okay, this is what it means. And I just go over it. I don't go for every single page, obviously, but I go for, like, I open a random page and I'm like, let me test myself. Let me see, do I know this? And then I check, and then if I know, then I know. If I don't know, then I need to go over it again. When it comes for the literature part, it's just like English, so you should already know how to do that from my last video if you want to check that out. Remember, I have the link. And for the speaking, because there's different things you need to know about, like you have to choose a theme and then you have to talk about it. So I just wrote like simple points about it, like things I needed to like remember to then say. I wrote them down here. And then sometimes I'll go over it. And I have just like, it's really short for each one. It's just like, this page is so small. This is like the size of my hand. It's so tiny. So really, you don't have to do much work. You do, like, if anything, you do more in the beginning to start it out. But then later on, it's just like, oh, I have the book. I can do whatever I want. I can just go over it. It's easy. And then for maths, it's a bit more heavy than GCSE. Because there's a lot of things you need to learn. Now, I chose a really bad book, because the paper of this book is much thinner than this one. So I had a leak in my bag because I didn't close my bottle properly. And then what happened was it messed with the book. So be careful with your water bottles. So for maths, I would just like, I wrote the things that I needed to know, but you should like know what they mean and how to use them. I just have it here like in case like I have an emergency and I'm like, oh my god, I don't know what this is. I have an exam, I need to know the simple thing. And I come here and I'm like, okay, I know the formula for acceleration, whatever, yeah? For the trigonometric identities, vectors. So, and if I have space at the back, so if I want to write anything, like, maybe you can even do questions here, like example questions of things that you find really hard, and you write them here, and then if you want to go back to it and check how the working out was done, you don't have to carry, because for maths A-level, you have this big chunky book, and you don't want to be carrying that around. So I advise you do this, because I, like, my back, every day I take that book to school, I die, literally. So yeah, that was just a quick video on what I did for A-levels comparing to GCSE. So if you're in need of some help, you don't know which way you should revise and what you should do, like you would just have like free subjects, effectively. You'd have free subjects, so you can have three different books for each one. And if they're all like sciences, I advise you have like an A5 sized book. But if you have something like maths, you don't need a really big one. You can get an even smaller book. So yeah, this is like what I wanted to tell you. If you found it useful, leave a like. If you want to know more about tricks and tips on how to like improve and get better grades, I am like doing a series of videos on like how you can improve and what things can you do and what things I did, which like I think they're bulletproof technically, because even at A levels I am getting A's, so I must be doing something right. Okay, right? So yeah, make sure you share it with your friends because they might really benefit from this. And yeah, subscribe, leave a comment if you have any questions, if you want anything, like if you want me to do a video on something. And yeah, bye!